Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this is lecture number 10.2. We are continuing with the dimensional analysis. The topic we discussed in the earlier lecture, need for dimensional analysis and method of dimensional analysis. And we continue here with similitude, types of similitude, dimensionless parameters, application of dimensionless parameters, and model analysis. The learning outcome to the student at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to define non-dimensional numbers and their significance. They explain the different types of models. Similitude. The model and the prototype should be mechanically similar. So, in the dimensional analysis, after forming the functional relationship among the variables in terms of pi terms or non-dimensional numbers, then we have to conduct the model test or model analysis. For conducting the model test, the model and the prototype should be mechanically similar for the model analysis. So, the model is the miniature of the real project, real machine or the component. The real item, real machine or the engine or the component is called as prototype. So, the model and the prototype should be mechanically similar for the model analysis. To achieve the mechanical similarity of the model and the prototype, they should have geometric similarity, kinematic similarity, and dynamic similarity. And geometric similarity, both the model and the prototype should be identical in shape and differ only in the size. The geometric similarity is said to exist between the model and the prototype if the ratio of all the corresponding linear dimensions are equal. So, models which are not geometrically similar are known as geometrically distorted models. So, for the conditions, so the geometric, so for example, you have a dam. We cannot, after designing the dam, we have to conduct the model test. Now, we have to take a miniature of the dam by reducing some size. That is what the relationship between the model and the prototype is what called as the geometrical similarity. There should be some scale reduction. Then we take the miniature, that is the model of the dam. We conduct the test on the model. We conduct the test on the model. The conditions of operation should be similar to the prototype. So, we stimulate the conditions for operation in the laboratory level and we conduct the test with the model. Then we take the data. We take the results of the model, experiment with the model. And that will be true for the real-time prototype also. That is what the understanding, that is the advantage of the model analysis. Let Lm is the length of the model, Hm is the height of the model, Dm is the diameter of the model, Am is the area of the model, Vm is the volume of the model. All are in linear dimensions. And Lp, Hp, Dp, Ap and Vp are the corresponding values of the prototype. So, the linear dimensions are given here. Now, for geometrical similarity, the condition Lm by Lp equal to Hm by Hp equal to Dm by Dp. So, L is the length. Lm, length of the model divided by length of the prototype, height of the model divided by the height of the prototype, diameter of the model divided by the diameter of the prototype should be equal to Lr, length ratio. Similarly, where Lr is called as scale ratio or the scale factor for the length. Then, similarly, area ratio, Ar equal to Am divided by Ap. Am is the area of the model, Ap is the area of the prototype. Volume ratio Vr equal to Vm divided by Vp, volume of the model divided by volume of the prototype. So, these are all the conditions, these are all the parameters we have to calculate for geometrical similarity. Then, kinematic similarity. For kinematic similarity, the model and the prototype should go identical velocities in magnitude and direction. Let V1m, V2m are the velocity of the model at the point 1 and 2 respectively. V1p, V2p are the velocity of the prototype at point 1 and 2 respectively. A1m, A2m are the acceleration of the model at point 1 and 2. and A1P and A2P are the acceleration of the prototype at point 1 and 2 respectively. So, the, for kinematic similarity, we must have velocity ratio V1M by V1P equal to V2M by V2P and acceleration ratio A1M divided by A1P equal to A2M divided by A2P. That is what the condition for kinematic similarity. Then dynamic similarity. For dynamic similarity, the model and the prototype should have identical forces. So, F1M, FVM, FIM, FVM, FGM, they are the inertia force, viscous force and gravitational force of the model. Similarly, FIP, FVP and FGP are the corresponding value, inertia force, viscous force and the gravitational force of the prototype. For dynamic similarity, the force ratio FIM divided by FIP equal to FVM divided by FVP equal to FGM divided by FGP. So, we have to calculate the force ratio for the dynamic similarity. So, any model and the prototype, when you prepare the model from the prototype, so we have to, the model and the prototype should satisfy the three conditions, geometric similarity, dynamic similarity and kinematic similarity. We have to calculate the parameter for the three similarities, geometric similarity, kinematic similarity and the dynamic similarity. Then the non-dimensional numbers. So, in the model analysis or dimensional analysis, the non-dimensional numbers plays a very important role. First non-dimensional number in fluid mechanics is Reynolds number. Reynolds number is defined as the ratio of inertia force to the viscous force. We define the inertia force equal to mass into acceleration. So, mass equal to rho into volume, density into volume, acceleration equal to velocity by time. So, rho into volume by time divided by into velocity. So, rho into AV into V. So, that is rho A V square. Inertia force equal to rho A V square. And the viscous force equal to shear stress into area, which is tau into A. So, which is tau equal to mu into du by dy into A. So, du by dy equal to V by L, velocity by length. So, mu into V A by L. Now, substitute for Reynolds number. Reynolds number equal to rho A V square by mu V A L, which is rho V L by mu, or V L by mu by rho equal to V L by nu. For pipe flow through the pipeline, so Reynolds number equal to V D by nu. So, the length is replaced by the diameter. So, what is the significance of this Reynolds number? Reynolds number signifies the relative predominance of inertia force to the viscous force in the fluid flow. It is used to distinguish whether the flow is laminar or turbulent. So, the flow, when the Reynolds number is less than 2000, the flow is laminar for pipe flow. If it is greater than 2000, the flow becomes turbulent. Flow is considered as turbulent. And the Froude number is defined as the square root of ratio of inertia force to the gravity force. So, gravity force equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity. So, rho into volume is the mass into g, acceleration due to gravity, rho AL into g. So, Froude number equal to square root of inertia force by the gravitational force. So, rho A V square by rho AL g. So, that is equal to V by square root of L into g. And then Euler number defined as the square root of ratio of inertia force to the pressure force. So, Euler number EU equal to FI divided by FP. Inertia force divided by the pressure force. Inertia force equal to rho A V square and pressure force equal to pressure into area. So, that is equal to V divided by square root of P by rho. Euler number equal to V, velocity divided by square root of P by rho. Then Weber number. So, Weber number is defined as the square root of the ratio of inertia force to the surface tension force. So, Weber number WE equal to square root of FI by FS, which is rho A V square, square root of rho A V square divided by sigma into L. So, that is equal to V by square root of sigma into rho into L. And Mach number. So, Mach number equal defined as the square root of ratio of inertia force to the elastic force. So, square root of Fi by Fe. So, rho A V square by K into A. Inertia elastic force is equal to K into A. So, this equal to V divided by square root of K by rho. So, among the non-dimensional number what we discuss here, so in our discussion fluid mechanics, you will be frequently using the Reynolds number. So the Reynolds number is the only useful non-dimensional number in the in our fluid mechanics analysis. And then types of model. So the in the model analysis, we have to have the dimensional, the similarity among the between the model and the prototype. And there are two types of model. One is undistorted model and distorted model. So first, the undistorted model. So an undistorted model is geometrically similar to its prototype, and that is the scale ratio of the corresponding linear dimensions of the model and the prototype are the same. So that is the prototype and model, they are identically the same, excepting the dimension, excepting the scale ratio. The result obtained in the model test are easily used to predict the performance of the prototype. Undistorted model. So the result obtained using the undistorted model, testing in the undistorted model, will be extended for the prototype. In such a model, the design and construction of the model and the implementation of the model results are easier and simpler. Distorted model. So distorted model are not geometrically similar to its prototype. Here the different scale ratio are used for the linear dimension. Examples of distorted models are river, dam across very wide river, harbor. Distorted models are used to simulate the situation very closer to the real time condition. So undistorted model, when the three dimensions are equal, almost equal, we can use. Whereas for the real time model, you take a long dam, so the length will be very long, but the height will be small comparing with the length. But here we cannot use the same scale ratio for length and the height. So that is why it is called as distorted model. We have to use different scale ratio for the two dimensions. So it's geometrically not similar. That is what the distorted model. Then the distorted model have the following distortion, geometric distortion. The distortion of dimensions results due to the adoption of different scales for vertical and horizontal dimensions. So we have to use the vertical scale ratio and horizontal scale ratio. Material distortion, it involves different materials for model and the prototype. Distortion by hydraulic quantities, this is due to the certain uncontrollable hydraulic quantities such as velocity and the discharge, velocity, discharge, etc. The merits of the distorted model, due to increase in the depth of fluid, accurate measurement are made possible. Due to the increase in the depth of the fluid, accurate measurement are made possible. The surface tension can be reduced to a minimum value. The model size can be sufficiently reduced, thereby its operation is simplified and the cost is reduced. The Reynolds number of the flow in the model can be increased, that will yield better results, because we are using a smaller type. We can use a small, very small model comparing with the prototype. Demerits of distorted model, the pressure and the velocity distribution are not truly reproduced. Slopes of the riverbed, the earth cut and dikes cannot be truly reproduced. It is difficult to extrapolate and interpolate the results obtained from the distorted models. So we can use only for this particular model and prototype setup. So model and the prototype. So you cannot extrapolate the data for another prototype of similar size, similar type. The advantages of model analysis. The model tests are quite economical and convenient. With the help of model test, the performance of the prototype can be predicted in advance. Before constructing the dam, before constructing the real airplane, from the model analysis, we can predict the performance of the prototype, performance of the real airplane, real ship or real dam. Because the design of a real dam or the ship and putting into operation, putting into test, it is very costly. That is why we are going for the model analysis. So model testing, model analysis, it is very economical to predict the performance of the real-time machine or the prototype. Model testing can be used to detect and rectify the defects of actual structure and machine before constructing it. So when you conduct the model test, we can predict the performance. where the model is deviating from the actual design, that we can identify. Accordingly, we can change the design, and when you make the prototype, all the corrections can be carried out and we can make a perfect prototype, perfect real-time machine or the structure. Model testing will help in predicting the safety and reliability of the parts used in the structure or the machine. So, by conducting the test with the model, so we can easily predict the safety and reliability of the parts used in the structure and the machine. So, the model analysis, it plays very important role in engineering design and implementation. So, before we make a real-time, the big structure or a big building or a big ship, we can make a model and we do all types of tests with the model and we take the data, experimental result, and we can predict the performance of each and every component in the model, and we can use it, the result, for building, for designing the prototype. So, we stop here, and these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject, and you may find the fluid mechanics and machinery, which is useful for this particular subject. You can refer to it for additional information and problem in the subject. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of the subject mentioned here. You can subscribe and use the video lectures for your better learning and to pass in the GATE examination. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments. You subscribe the channel and you can write to my mail ID for any clarification. So, we'll meet again in another video lecture in the fluid mechanics. Thank you.